So what's better than an update? Just a short update. Let's get going. Hey everyone, I'm Peter Borchards and welcome to episode 7 of my series on building a new model railroad. Welcome to all my subscribers and especially welcome to all my new subscribers. There have been quite a few of you since my last video, so welcome. Thank you for joining. So in this episode, I'm just going to show you what I've been doing for the last few weeks. Unfortunately, I haven't been doing much. Work's got in the way as usual. So I'll just give you a quick update on what I have done. I've been testing the Helix as well, so I'll show you a short video of that. I've tested it with one of my freight trains, sort of the typical freight train that will be going up the Helix, as well as my passenger locomotive. I've also been continuing with a bit of the track planning, and I'll show you a bit of that as well. What I have done is I've changed from using Xtrack CAD as my track planner to using Anyrail. I'll show you what I've done with that. Initially just doing the Helix and adding the yard, the existing yard I've got, the yard behind me from the old layout, just adding that into the track plan. And then in the next few weeks, I'm going to start working on the main yard, the main freight yard for the layout on the lower staging. So I'll just give you a quick overview of what I've done with that so far. So I have an update on that sort of probably closer to Christmas or whenever they get the track to me and when I get a chance to start adding the track. And of course, make sure if you haven't already subscribed, click on the subscribe button down below and click on that little bell icon to be notified of my future updates. There'll be quite a few coming in the next few months, so you don't want to miss any of those. Anyway, so let's get started.
So I'm just going to show you how far I've got with my track planning. As you can see, I'm now using Anyrail for my track planning. I was using Xtrack CAD, but after trying Anyrail, I decided I actually preferred it. It had a lot of features that made it a lot easier to use than Xtrack CAD. And it's also got a nice 3D view as well, which gives you a better representation of what you're doing. Just makes it easier to try to visualize your track plan. So what I've done is I've got my existing yard from my old layout, which is this one here, which I'm using purely for testing purposes at the moment. I was going to incorporate it into the new layout, but I've actually decided I might start from scratch with this yard. So as you can see here, I've added the boards for each section. This is the board for the Helix, it's about 3 foot wide. Then I've got 2 6-foot boards. So that's going to give me a nice 12-foot section for 2 yards. So what I'm going to do is this is going to become a freight yard, and next to it will be a yard for the Metro passenger service. And each yard will then connect to the corresponding track on the Helix. So you can see here the outer track will be for the freight, the inner track will be for the passenger service. I've also added the new Helix in just to make it easier for me to work out how I'm going to do everything. So this is the basis for determining the heights of the whole layout. So now I've got that in place, I know what I can do and what I can fit in. So let me just show you the 3D view, because I find that's quite useful for just visualization. I'm still getting used to the way this 3D view works. So I'll switch off the ground because that's quite confusing for around the Helix. There we go, it's better. Okay, so you can see there, that's my existing yard and this is the Helix. I can see it makes it look really useful for visualization. You can see the exact height of it, how everything is going to fit in, exactly where it comes out and the level it comes out at. Now bear in mind, this is the lower level. So that's going to be my lower level staging. And the top of the Helix here goes up to the first level of my layout, so effectively the ground level of the layout. And that is going to be the first section I'll be working on. As I work my way around, I'll eventually get to the other end and I might possibly have another Helix going up to a second main level. I'll just see how I get along with the first level. This space here from this side all the way to here is effectively my available space. So that is the garage that the layout is in. You can see it goes up to there. That's a good amount of space I'm working with. And what I'm going to do at the moment is, you can see on the lower level I've got 2 6-foot boards. On the upper level, or the first level, the ground level, I'm going to have another 2 6-foot boards, as well as another 3.5-foot board, and that'll take it almost to the edge of the room. I've got another bit of storage over here that I'm keeping clear, but that's going to give a nice amount of space. So it's going to be about 15.5 foot along here, which would be great. And then I'll just continue it up this way in sort of like a U shape. But I'll show you that as I carry on with the planning process. So what I've been doing in the meantime is I've been testing different train lengths and locomotives to see how many locomotives I need to get to the top of the hill. This Helix is quite a steep gradient. It's about 2.2%, which is quite steep for most Helixes are probably about 1.2-1.3% or something like that. At the moment I've been testing with my auto racks, and it takes sort of 2 scale trains Gevos to get to the top of the hill at a nice steady speed. It takes about 4 minutes to get from the bottom here up to the top of the Helix, and they go gently, you know, they don't have any wheel spin or anything, so that's quite good. I'm now going to be testing with some coal gondolas and also with my container trains, just to see how many locomotives I need. At the moment, it seems like 2 would probably be good. Anything shorter than that, any trains shorter, I should be able to do with one locomotive. But as most of these be coming from the main staging yard, most of them will have two at the front. What I've also ordered is a set of laser cut boards that I'll be putting over here. So these will be all laser cut, just so I don't have to build them myself. It makes it look a bit quicker rather than having to fiddle around with cutting wood and everything. So those should be arriving in the next few weeks. I can then start putting this together, and once I've designed my track work, I can then start building the yards. Now I'm going to just be using standard Pico track for this, the code 55. The reason for that is they're not visible yards, so I don't have to worry about making the track look fancy or anything. I'm not going to use fast tracks turnouts for these. I mean, there are quite a few turnouts here, so it's probably better if I don't use that. So it just makes it easier and quicker for me to do. I'm used to working with the Pico track, so that will fit in nicely over here. And I'll be doing the two yards, getting them all working. Once they're all up and working and connected, I can then start on the upper level, or the first level of the layout. So as I said right at the beginning of the series, I'm going to be doing they call the TOMA method, the one module approach. The model railroad hobbyist coined that phrase. So I'm going to be getting each board finished before I move on to the next one. And it just means I've got a finished yard at the bottom before I get to the top. And when I get to the top, I can really test it nicely because I've got a complete finished yard at the bottom. I don't have to go back and redo stuff or anything. It'll be completely done. So the wiring, the track work, everything will be completely finished before I move up to the next level. So that will be coming, I'll show you in my next video the boards, if they've arrived by then, just what they look like. And I'll show you how far I've got on with the planning. I'm going to be having more time obviously over the Christmas period, so I'll be having more time to work on the track planning, and I'll show you how I get on with that.
Okay, I hope that helped you understand what I've been doing in the last couple of weeks. As you can see, it hasn't been much, but hopefully in the next few weeks I'll get some more done. I'm going to just start doing more on the track planning. As I showed you briefly, I've done a little start on it, added the Helix and the current staging yard for my Metro stock. And I'm just going to start working on the track plan for the yard for my freight service. So that will be coming up in the next couple of weeks as well. Hopefully by then we'll have more track, the rest of the track arriving, the rest of the Kato Uni track for the Helix, so I can start getting that all installed. I'm going to be showing you how I add the feeders as well, making a slight change to the Uni track's feeders. So that's all coming up in the next few weeks. In the meantime, if you haven't already subscribed, please click on the subscribe button down below and click on the little bell icon to be notified of all the upcoming updates. So until next time, keep safe and see you soon.